words.
No. Don't pay attention. Look at me. Welcome to the podcast.
Fucking vocalists. They're all like that. Look at me. I'm the vocalist.
Can't even hear me. Can you hear me now?
Hello. Welcome to the Punk Black
Welcome
Podcast.
Welcome to the podcast.
Welcome again.
Unfortunately, I can hear you twice now that I've been slated with the task of monitoring the audio.
Oh, is it like delayed in the headphones a little bit? You got some. Actually,
there's no real latency on it.
Oh, okay. Well.
Yeah. Ooh. Courtesy of my new fancy $50.
Whoa,
Amtrak Solo.
$50. Okay.
In audio, I think they gave me some money for something at some point.
Stop throwing Punk Black's money in our face.
Hey, Working Class Music was demoing M-Audio stuff before it was
cool. M-Audio, please give us money. We have your lowest end shit.
Anyway, welcome to Lit edition of the Punk Black Podcast, even though this is going to come out after day. Tomorrow's Labor Day weekend.
We can't mention it's too political.
Ah, gotcha. Well, I'm going to bleep all of that out.
Welcome to beep, beep, beep. Yeah. Actually, because it's going to be beep,
this
beep,
is
beep.
The most vulgar holiday in existence.
It's all trash. People celebrate it or trash.
They don't even celebrate it here on Earth. But yeah, welcome to the Punk Black Podcast.
What
How you doing, Punk Black?
Origins of
This episode is called Three Guys in a Computer, and
I do not want to see that.
It's like, is this what this podcast is gonna be? It's just guys on computers now.
Where's
your
computer?
Guys on your computers? Is that all this? I'm just mad.
What are you, an old man?
I left mine at home. Fucking
your kids are always looking in your cell phones
your
computers and your screens.
Jesus, back in my day, we had to fucking watch a big TV with an ass on it.
What?
Yeah. What?
Nelson.
You know the fucking TVs with the fucking, with the back deck going on?
Oh.
Yeah.
The TV had an ass.
It had an ass on
not,
it.
Oh. Not that you were watching ass on the TV.
I mean,
that was confusing.
That was the way you said that, Nelson.
I mean, yeah. I mean,
I'm like, was it BET Uncut?
We can get into that if you want to.
What was that, sex documentary type show they used to go on? Was it like on HBO? No, it was on HBO.
Like
it was
Real like, Sex Now.
Real Sex Now? Was
yeah,
like,
that was HBO. Dad's going and there was like some other stuff.
It's like when you, I saw a meme that like reflected my childhood so much. It's like you're watching something, but like you got like a Cartoon Network on last.
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as like you hear the door open, you're like, last.
Oh, boy. Those Girls Gone Wild commercials.
My dad's like, oh, so
oh,
you're
boy.
Just exactly.
Jesus Christ.
So you're just watching cartoons on mute.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
I like it better that way when it's late.
I'm trying to disturb you, Father.
I love you so much, and I know how much you work for us, Father.
BET Uncut was a weird thing.
You know, my dad, he'd be like, damn right.
BET Uncut was weird.
I feel like you guys are older than me, so you probably have a better like.
You feel like we're older than you. Like you just like he senses it. He's like, I feel something in the air.
There's a feeling in the force.
It's not like it's like the gray hair or the sense of despair around you.
But yeah, like I remember being in like elementary school when it was happening. You guys were like what, like high school sophomores at the time?
I was probably in middle school. Me and you aren't that far apart. How old are you? 26, right?
Yes.
26. I'm only 5 years older than you.
Okay.
Beza, if you were middle, I was already a professional gospel rapper. So that means.
He's not lying.
I've heard it. Saw the old picture of him
straight.
With fucking cornrows.
Glory to
oh,
glory
did you?
To
yeah,
glory.
That's right, because we looked it up. Yeah.
Yeah, man. Oh, that was.
Cornrows cult. Oh, you didn't see single braids cult. It was like, they're called singles, right? Where you got like the little singles braids.
Oh,
plats. Plats.
I saw those too. Those were all in his old MySpace thing.
Oh, wow. I wonder if my music is still up on MySpace.
Yeah, we went on a little deep dive on an old episode of the podcast.
Oh, man.
Yeah, but if you haven't realized, this is the Punk Black Podcast. I'm Nelson. Nelson Crawford, to be exact.
I'm Arcade.
I'm Von Phoenix.
Arcade Colton Von Phoenix.
Wait, are we going to let him introduce us? Are we going to let this guy?
Are you going to talk into your mic?
This guy introduces.
Do you forget it's
here? Yeah, I'm actually like my,
I do forget it's here.
I don't know if you got the email I sent you, but I sent my intro. It starts with the first of his name.
Okay, here we go.
The sure illustrious, badass, father of dragons, father of Punk Black.
Let's see if I can find this.
Yeah, just dig it up.
Ah, here, it's in my trash.
Ah, so
That's why. And I think it was in the spam folder or something.
Dang, he got Punk Black emails going to spam.
Jeez. Well, let's talk about the vodka-sized elephant in the room.
Closed.
So, yeah, yesterday I walked into a liquor store.
Here we go. One of Nelson's great stories.
You know, I guess he saw my look, and I was ready to be bothered. You know, because that's just what I assume when somebody's walking up to me, that I'm going to be bothered and not...
Especially in a liquor store.
Right? I'm like, what good could come of this?
We're all shamefully drinking. We're all trying
to get alcohol. Going to a liquor store is like going into a porno store. Like, everyone's just like, no eye contact, hands down. It's so, like, all right, let me just get my business and pay and leave.
Yeah, this guy
they're not
up
the
to
same.
Me.
Those are not similar.
I mean, I've never been in a porn store, so I don't know.
Exactly, because you guys got your porn from the internet.
Yeah.
Back when I was your age.
Jesus Christ. Are you old or not? Pick a lane.
Damn.
This guy walks up to me and he's like, so what do you usually drink? And I was just like, I mean, everything, you know. And so, like, I was like, I don't know, man, like vodka, I guess. And
he's how like, was he dressed?
He was dressed like, fuck. He was dressed like he worked at a men's warehouse.
Ah, okay. I was hoping you'd say pirate, but men's
so
warehouse.
So dressed well?
Yes, sure. Mm.
Okay.
He looked like he was...
Like he got his clothes off a mannequin?
He looked like a business rep from K&G.
so fancy. You know, I'm thinking fancy.
Yeah, the black men's warehouse.
Because I forgot. I've had people walk up to me in liquor stores, but they're girls in tight outfits. And they're just like, hey, don't you want to buy this? I'm just like, ma'am, I've come here already knowing what I want to buy. Leave me alone.
That's a whole story in and of itself, but yeah.
Oh, I can tell when you said buy this, were you pointing to like the bottle of liquor? Or
it was a bottle of liquor. Okay, you know, there's liquor.
Let them know that you're pointing to the bottle
there's
of liquor.
There's liquor companies who hire models to go into liquor stores and
yeah, they go
bars
too.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Usually when they're in bars is when I have less patience for it. Because like, I mean, just as a sidebar, once like me and my buddy had like, spent the day, it was Xander, fucking, we spent the day fucking cleaning out his basement, like setting up a studio down there, and we were drinking Guinness while we did it, terrible mm-hmm. idea, but we get to this place, and we order some nice cocktails, and this nice girl walks up to us, and...
Just trying to make a buck.
Yeah, and asks us if we would like some free Miller Lights. And we looked at her and we're just like, well, you can put them down, but we're not going to have it. Because it was just, everything was too far gone.
Yeah.
You think I'm going to step out of the car and have a Miller Lite? No. You know, okay, so back to this guy. So he's like, what are you drinking? I'm like, Tito's. And he's like, ah, we are also corn distilled. And just starts going in. And I'm like,
oh, wow. What do you mean, we? Yeah, I didn't know who you are.
Like, he's like, yeah, I have a vodka
men's warehouse guy
called Island John Vodka. And I'm like, okay, sure, yes. And so, like, halfway through him talking, I'm like, so what size do you guys sell your bottles in? Because I'm just like, can I buy it and have you leave me alone now? You know?
Mm-hmm.
And so he's like, oh, he takes me over to their display. And he's like, well, what do you do? And I'm like a media manager, you know, video editor. And, like, you know, Punk Black comes up, and he's just like, oh, okay, so you guys are, like, big in Atlanta. And I was like, I mean, I don't want to do my own.
Well, I mean.
But we do have a festival coming up that's sponsored by PBR. Right. Come to Punk Black Fest in October.
And Jameson and Altos now.
And Jameson what? And Altos now. And now possibly Island John, hopefully.
This is dangerous.
So,
we could get this alcohol for free.
So much free booze. And so he's like, okay. And I'm like, yeah, I do, like, a podcast for them, you know, photos and stuff. And he's like, oh, when do you guys record? We're like, twice a month. And he's like, okay, so do you want to just take this bottle and, you know, take it to the show and let us know what you think? And I'm like, so I can just have this? And he's like, yeah, man. And I was like, okay. And I just walked out of the liquor store because I was I was like, I don't want to buy
anything if
and,
you're
and,
giving and, this like, to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks, bud. And, like, yeah, I got some Island John and then went home and drank a bit. And we're going to have a bit on this podcast.
Okay, so, guys, I don't know a lot about alcohol. I usually just, I have the stuff I drink and then I just drink whatever.
Thanks, Kevin. Thanks,
whatever.
Kevin John.
Thanks, Kevin John. And then I you know, drink whatever Vaughn puts in front of me. But is it bad if we've been drinking brown and then we go to white?
Not fucking do it. Oh, or if you do it, just do a shot.
Yeah, it's like, well, we...
Oh, okay, just a little bit. Don't, like, go in,
you will straight up fuck yourself.
I also want to take that
I'll straight up fuck myself.
No. That is a Punk Black tip. If you start with one color of alcohol, fucking stick with that for the night, because the next day you will be fucked. as far as like hangovers.
Okay, there's
stuff.
A part of me that wants to trust Von and listen to him. There's a part of me that wants to prove him wrong.
Hey man, I'm the all part about of you... I'm all about fucking integration. You know.
And Von, this is a black-owned company. Yeah. Von, when did you start hating black people?
I was saying the part of you that was approving wrong is going to wake up tomorrow with a killer hangover.
All right, I'm just going to get a little. I'm just going to get a little.
I got a white girlfriend. I got a black side piece. You know, it's all over the place.
I'll try this
one. Nelson, don't just slip that in.
White
like,
and brown, baby.
No, we need to. Nelson, we need to unpack that. Nelson. While they're distracted with alcohol, as usual, sent this in. White girlfriend, black side piece. Let's go, guys. Like what?
Have you guys heard the? Have you heard the new Sacoma album?
I'm not familiar.
I'm not even familiar with Sacoma.
Sacoma nuts.
Cheers to that. Cheers to that. Cheers. No, right now. Wait, don't even fucking think about it. Cheers. Cheers. Don't fucking think about it. Cheers. We're cheersing. Oh, you have cheers. There it is. Okay. Moving forward. Move past this real quick. Real quick. Don't let it stink up the rest of the podcast. No. Nope. Open your emails.
Was that a joke or is that the running of a man?
Oh, no. It's falling. Von, you asked too much about it. It's gonna roll everything down with us. Oh no, we just have to. No, we just have to move past it. Move past it.
Oh boy,
don't let it suck into bring up a topic. Something that's not this. God damn it. Dragon Con. Hey, Dragon Con's going on.
Yeah, it's going on.
You can tell
on
by the traffic
as we speak. Yeah, I dealt with the traffic. As a Lyft driver, it was a fucking nightmare.
Pretty smooth.
It's okay.
All right, wait, pause. Okay. I expect all alcohol to have a little bitterness to it. This is bitter. Like, how much? I mean, seriously, how smooth can vodka be? And but I will say, vodka's not my.
It's my.
I'm a whiskey guy.
I'm glad you asked. We can use this as a sponsor plug for Altos, our new sponsor for the Von Black Festival.
We're getting angry. Wait,
no. Altos
Kevin
makes
John
tequila,
tomorrow.
Don't they, actually?
You guys shitted on my it's like, free bottle of vodka.
Okay, come on.
Hey, guys. Are you drinking vodka and it's a little bitter? Make sure you get Royal Snacks Neon Gummy Worms. Oh. Royal Snacks Neon Gummy Worms for the bitter alcohol.
I remember we were going to do this to try and gain some sponsorships. They are just all
hey, yes.
Oh, man. But the bottle looks great.
Yeah.
It's not bad vodka.
No, it's not bad at all.
It's good.
What's the normal price of it? Did you
see that? It's exactly what it should be.
I think that bottle goes for like $18.
That's reasonable for this taste.
Yeah, probably $20 in Atlanta.
Yeah, no, it's not too bitter to me. It's pretty smooth going down. It doesn't have that like really strong taste, but
hey, I'm a Tito's guy through and through, but if you're going to give it to me for free, I'll have it.
Also, support your local black businesses.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the main reason why we're talking about
right,
this
basically,
vodka,
like, honestly.
Is yes, there's a well-dressed black man who gave it to me.
I really don't drink vodka, but if a black, well-dressed black man gives me anything, I'll take it.
Exactly.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah.
What does that sound, Von?
I mean, yeah, no, sure, not anything.
Not anything?
Yeah, if a guy's like, hey, man. Like, what do my keys smell like? Can't take it.
But he's well-dressed, right?
I mean, doesn't mean it's good.
Okay, fair
doesn't
enough.
Doesn't mean it's good.
Anyways, Dragon Con. I brought up Dragon Con because I was like, hey, Halloween's coming up, and we're going to have a punk black Halloween show. I don't think it's been announced because we haven't even done it, but it's later on announced.
We have so much
what are you guys' top three ideas for doing either?
Oh, shit. Von, can you restart the thing?
Pause. This is the pause.
I am trying. I am over here doing my damnness.
Well, I can't get up.
To do God's work and order myself some Uber Eats.
Doing God's work.
Well, I can't get up, so I mean.
I'm not going to take these headphones off.
Oh, so the audio's still recording, yeah, but the video's stopped recording.
Yeah.
So, just so you guys know.
That means it's time for you to yell.
This is, let's, okay, so I have to talk.
Turned on Cole so many
times. What? You're just so loud. He was like, you're not on your mic, and now I'm too close to my mic, and I'm too loud in my mic?
Yes.
When your co-hosts are being annoying, eat a... Royal Snacks Neon Gummy Worms. I'm surprised you ate half the pack before you got here, selfish.
I mean,
Neon Snack Gummy Worms. Are your co-hosts annoying you?
Well, the video's back.
You deserve a gummy worm.
You trying to do their job?
But yes, their job is to annoy you. Anyways.
So yeah, you want to know
what is your top three cosplay or Halloween costumes that you guys have been thinking about? Well, what do you feel? What do you feel? Shit. What are you feeling?
I usually don't.
Not at all.
I mean, well, I don't know. I was never a big cosplay guy, you know, cosplay person.
Same.
Cause like, I mean, I'm sure I could. I don't know, man. I never got into it. I've had a couple ideas.
I just had an amazing idea.
What?
Was it to interrupt Nelson while he was talking? Because that was very rude.
That's my job is to interrupt Nelson. Well, you won't say it in front of him, but you told me, like, hey, man, make sure you interrupt him every time you get. I'll slide you an extra 20. That's what you told me.
Cool. You were supposed to keep that to yourself.
You're getting paid?
No, because you're going to call me up. wait, y'all are getting paid? What if we make somebody dress up? We pick a costume for each other for Halloween.
This idea does not sound planned.
No, that's awful. The thing. This like is great. That way you have to do it.
Oh my God.
What? All right, we'll just keep it in the air. Go ahead about your top three, because I'll go to my top three.
If you had to pick an idea for somebody, for either
you
or Vaughn, for either of us, what would it be?
For Nelson, I would pick Lieutenant Mustang. Wow. Is it lieutenant or sergeant?
From Full Metal Alchemist.
Full Metal Alchemist, yeah. With the coat? Yeah. That's what I pick.
Me and Nelson are making the same faces.
Yeah, like, all right.
That's perfect.
Not
perfect
thing that came
for
to
Vaughn.
Mind.
Zex Marquis.
Who's that?
Full Metal Alchemist. And not Full Metal Alchemist, but Gundam Wing.
That actually makes sense because he has long ass hair and he's wearing a mask.
And he has the mask. Yeah. Yes, perfect. And he's an asshole, just like you. So perfect. What do you guys pick for
like
me?
Vaughn could do a couple of people from Gundam Wing.
Oh yeah,
he's got the dramatic enough face.
Okay, so now you have to pick
the
one
dramatic
for me
face.
And
yeah. I feel like my face is the opposite of dramatic. Like especially all my pictures are like the same facial expression.
I can't see your face without your voice, and your voice is dramatic, so I can't separate the two. Because your voice is like, your face is kind of like, hey, don't I look like a child? And your voice is like, destiny will meet you this evening.
Jeez.
No, it goes, okay. Destiny will meet you this evening.
There it is.
Colt, for you, I'd have you dress up as, what's his name? Dude from Black Dynamite.
Black Dynamite?
No, the dude who rhymes everything in Black Dynamite.
I never watched Black Dynamite.
I can't remember his name.
This isn't an anime.
Okay.
Dang.
Has your co-host just insulted your intelligence?
All right, we're not doing this spot again this many times this week. Okay. Okay, you could be what's his face from Shaman King? The fucking main character dude from Shaman King.
Yo?
Yeah, he could be Yo from Shaman King.
I have to look that up because...
And Vaughn,
I stopped watching anime after 1998, so let's see here.
Jesus Christ.
I'm joking, but
Vaughn,
not really.
You could do Whoopi Goldberg.
Oh, man. She is amazing and beautiful.
Whoopi Goldberg is kind of an asshole.
It's not an anime. What is wrong with you, Nelson?
That is an anime.
Wait, which one? This guy?
That guy.
Cosplay isn't necessarily limited to anime.
You got all these white ass people dressing up as Asian characters and telling me how I can't because they're not that race.
And that's fair. And I didn't want to mean just anime. I wanted to like anything for Halloween. Vaughn, now you have to pick for Nelson and for me.
Do you want to talk about that? The great cosplay debate that shouldn't be a debate, it's just a dumbass argument.
What is the argument?
Where, you know, when people are like, oh, okay, so you're going to do a black version of that character? You know, like.
It's like, no, I'm just doing this.
Yeah,
this
you know
character.
What I mean? Because it's like, oh, so you're going to do a white version of that character. You
right,
know
because
mean?
Usually the character...
Usually they're Asian.
Right, so it's just like...
Like, what do you mean?
I can think of maybe one anime where... Because, like, Full Metal Alchemist,
they're
specifically like...
They're
specifically like, hey, these are, like, people from Europe. These are European characters or whatever. But, like, most of the time, they just, like, you know.
Demon Slayer and shit.
Like. Right. It's just like, no, these are obviously Asian people. And then it's just like, if you dress up as a white person like it, it's okay. That's, but if I dress up as a black person, it's like all the sudden.
Black version of it.
Right. It's like, no, dude, let's be real. Of course, I'm a black person dressing up in this. Like, cool. But, like, still, you're a white person dressing up at this. Yeah. It is so weird. It's like, it's weird the way, you know, the culture in this country seeps into everything. Like, we could just call it like, oh, people are tripping about this, about black people dressing up as anime, but people just trip on black people across the board, no matter what it is. So it like seeps into, like, you know, it's just the culture of everything. But I was like, all right, yeah, keep it coming, Colt. Here's your confidence juice. Keep the podcast going. Here it is.
I like this. Go on.
Is your co-host on a good rant? Make sure to pour him up some Elijah Craig.
Oh yes, Elijah Craig. Please give
Elijah
him
Craig. Honestly, ooh, honestly, out of all the sponsors we joked about, this is the sponsor we really want. Cheers, gentlemen. Cheers, gentlemen.
I still can't believe I got that sick over.
You throw make all you. This noise on here. All this clipping.
So
my choices for people's cosplay.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, because Cole just like interrupt me and just keep going.
I think we made our point about that. Fucking, if you're, you know, white, black, whatever, cosplay whoever you want.
Did your co-host make a point? Make sure to watch that. All right, so fine.
For Nelson, I would say Kuwabara from Yu Yu Hakusho.
Oh, okay.
Because I feel like you can. Yeah, your hair, I feel like you can.
Fucking
like,
Urameshi, what are you doing?
I feel like that would be badass.
Yeah, I could. Yeah.
Hold on. I can't keep up because I've never seen this anime. You said.
Yu Yu Hakusho? You
is that the one fucking with like the.
It's classic. It's like in the 90s sort of anime.
Goddamn Philistine. You don't know what Yu Yu Hakusho is? Jesus Christ.
Oh, I never watched it because I didn't like the animation.
What?
First of all, children, when I was your age, this was out along with Dragon Ball Z, Pokemon, which is, I saw a list, they talk about the most watched anime of all time, which is like, oh, what is it going to be? It's like, Dragon Ball passes by, Demon Slayer passes by, Bleach passes by, JoJo's Bizarre. No, the number one anime with the top watches is Pokemon.
Oh, well, yeah, because they've been on forever, and their their
and they're for all ages, so now. It's just like, no one gives a shit. It's just like, oh, I'm going to watch Pokemon because it's like, it's a cool, interesting thing, and, you know, people just watch it because whatever.
And Pokemon was actually really fucking good. It was. The Johto League.
For a while.
I will say, though, I watched, like, two episodes of this anime, and I wasn't convinced, so.
Wow.
Okay, so fucking Yu Yu Hakusho is the fucking truth.
It is, dude.
You can start with the theme song, Smile Bomb, which we did a video of today on Pop Black.
All right, well.
Hey, Nelson, drop it in right now.
What's happening? What's going on? Where am I?
I feel like we have to stop the podcast and have you listen to this song. It's gold. Yu Yu Hakusho is gold. Like, the whole thing is gold. All right,
we're going to do a classic punk black podcast anime fight.
What?
The way we always do, right, guys?
It wouldn't be an anime fight because you don't have a fucking ground to stand on saying Yu Yu Hakusho's not good. I bet I could think of
three animes better than Yu Yu Hakusho.
I'm saying you can't even say that it's
No. I bet.
Colt,
wait, you can't even say
Dark Tournament arc is undefeated. Dude.
And you can't even say that your
animes are better because you haven't seen Yu Yu Hakusho.
Make sure you eat a gummy worm when your co-hosts aren't listening to you. Wait, what are you saying? What did you say?
Yeah, Colt's the one not listening. I'm saying you can't decide that Yu Yu Hakusho is not good as other anime because you've only seen two fucking episodes.
And I wasn't convinced.
Wait, okay.
I wasn't convinced. And here's the thing. Maybe if you guys recommend what episodes to start at.
Start with.
Because you know how, like, you're trying to get into an anime, but here's the thing. It was on
Toonami.
Toonami. And I was just like, you know what? I'll give it a try. And I was just like, this seems like nonsense. And it was probably like in an arc or in the middle of something, I just never picked it back up.
You didn't even start from the beginning. You just started in a random place, and you're like, oh, it sucks.
I'm sorry, Vaughn. Have you ever started a random place of an anime and judged it?
Hold on, guys. This seems like a thing. Yeah, it's like, this seems like a thing with you guys.
And then Poke Black just broke up. I'm done. You're out of Poke Black. Oh, yeah? Well, I'm taking my half with me. You be your third? Yes, I guess.
I guess this is my second breakup at Punk Black.
Punk Black splits.
Because Holder's was
Vaughn keeps like Vaughn keeps the 80% that he owns. I take the 20%, which is like just I don't know.
Podcast.
It's just like the Punk Black street fashion idea I haven't done yet.
Colt thinks he has 20%.
No, I came up with the name, damn it. I would take the name with me if I would just be like Punk Black and add an extra C or something to the end of it.
Like an extra K.
You're right, an extra K, like, fuck you, dude. I'm just like, well, I have the correct spelling on Instagram.
Or start a new thing called Afro Punk Black.
Oh. Catchy. And I see what side Nelson is on.
Hey, then, don't.
No, honestly, I'm down to.
Don't make me fucking. Peter
there was
Parker
like, because I tried to watch two episodes. There was one episode I watched that was pretty cool.
I will give you this. The first, like, first season or first arc or so can be a little hit or miss. But I say once it gets to that Dark Tournament arc with the Chigoro brothers, it's fucking undefeated.
Guys, okay. So, yeah. I'm 65 years old. Like, this is like, am I really going to get into new anime at the late stages of my life?
I mean, this is one to, all of it's on Hulu. So, like, I would recommend it.
All of it's on Hulu?
Yeah.
Okay, bet. Cool.
Because that's all how right. I got my girlfriend to watch it, because, like, she was just like, oh,
okay,
you know,
so did I just start at the beginning?
I mean, if you're going to commit. If you're not
okay,
going to commit.
Okay, it's not like, okay, wait, wait.
Cool
it's
shit.
Not like One Piece, right?
No.
It's not like One Piece.
No.
This,
it has
you,
an ending.
No.
Nothing's like One Piece.
Yeah.
You idiot.
And honestly, One Piece wasn't
okay,
bad.
Okay, guys.
One Piece
you
isn't
know what?
You fucking dumbass, dude.
When your co-hosts are insulting you, take one of their gummy worms.
When your co-hosts
to spike
doing
them.
A stupid-ass ads.
Right, I'm back now. I had to order some
neon gummy worms.
Wait, have you seen One Piece before?
I've seen... Here's the thing.
This show's
no, no, for reals, because I said, like, I've seen, like, one episode of this. I've seen, like, two or three episodes of One Piece, and I was just like, meh. And I decided, like, not to... And, like, you could tell, like, the same thing. It's on Toonami. It's probably in the middle of an arc. I didn't find it very interesting. But, like, my thing with anime, and, like, I'll tell you a story. If I don't like the animation style, I won't watch it. Vaughn had to make me watch Code Geass.
Oh,
because I didn't like the big
very
eye
good.
Animation style.
Yeah.
But then once I sat down and watched, I was like, he's right. This is really fucking good. So,
and Yu Yu Hakusho would beat the shit out of Code Geass.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, are we doing anime battle?
Yu Yu Hakusho would beat the shit
the thing we always do, right, guys? We always do it. This is the thing we always do. We always do anime battle.
I don't remember us doing
what,
this
anime
battle?
All the time.
Since we're talking about anime, what is an anime that everybody loves that you guys just find to be a bit overrated?
Hmm.
Yeah.
I thought the obvious choice is Dragon Ball.
Ah, well.
Dragon Ball? Are you talking about Dragon Ball, which, I mean, are you talking about Dragon Ball the original, or are you talking about Dragon Ball Z, or Dragon Ball GT, or Dragon Ball Super?
Okay, let me go through the same thing with Dragon Ball, because I've heard several people say Dragon Ball Z is too hype, Dragon Ball GT, Dragon Ball Super, they're too hype, Dragon Ball the original is the best one by far.
Are
so
they,
I watched like a few episodes. I'm just like, I don't like Goku as a kid. That is like really, it comes down to him kind of flirting with, was it Chi-Chi? Or like the weird shit they have going on. I'm just like, guys.
He was not flirting with GT.
Yeah,
she was flirting with him or trying to get like, hey, I let you look at my panties. Her. And he's just like, well, maybe I can just punch you in the face and get out of my goddamn way, bitch.
See, yeah, Dragon Ball was like one of those quirky like 80s animes where Dragon Ball Z was like the 90s, it's edgy fucking power-ups, you know what I mean,
skateboards, Mountain Dew, ow.
To be honest, like all like Dragon Ball is, you know, a classic and really good. Dragon Ball Z, of course, that's my childhood. Dragon Ball GT is absolute fucking trash.
Well, no, I bring up Dragon Ball because everyone always says it's overrated, but like me personally, something that's overrated as an anime but everyone praises,
at least in your opinion, yes.
What?
Because mine, I want to know you guys first, because mine is going to start an argument.
I'm trying to think of an anime that's overrated that everyone likes.
Okay,
One Piece, because I liked One Piece at the beginning.
Here's,
it just
I'll say
long.
This one, but what I will honestly say is that I can't remember if I stopped watching it, if I didn't like it, or if I just was so busy, because I'm raising all my children here.
All 38 of them.
Yes.
It's actually 39 now.
Okay, because
nice.
It was Cowboy Bebop, and they did the other one with the samurai with the No, I like that one. I just haven't finished it.
Outlaw Star?
No, with the hip-hop soundtrack.
You still have Samurai Champloo?
Samurai Champloo?
I did like Samurai Champloo.
Yeah, okay, because like, I was about to go.
Like, you like Samurai Champloo. Like,
you do.
Yeah, you do.
I just didn't finish it.
Even if you think you don't, you do.
Which one was... Okay. Anime I don't like that everyone else likes.
Yeah.
I didn't finish Gundam Unicorn.
Well, that's
Gundam. That's a whole Gundam's in the One Piece category.
Gundam Unicorn was
Gundam
trash.
Is just was it? I like that. Here's the thing. I like the animation because I like the fact that the characters had like 80s hairdos. I was just like, this is different. It's like 2000, whatever. They have 80s hairdos. I found it, but I couldn't
if
really
you want to
get
see
into
80s
the story
hairdos.
Line.
You could always watch fucking Yu Yu Hakusho.
Yeah, fucking that Pompadour is undefeated, dude.
Exactly. Kuwabara. Come
on. All right, you guys go. I'm trying to think of like one.
Mine is Evangelion.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Didn't like it.
Because it's so 2D?
Didn't care for it.
It's probably just because it's ancient.
Well, that and I rewatched a lot of it and then rewatched the end of Evangelion and was just like...
Okay, I can't remember if this was the real ending or if it was like a side ending or what. Didn't at the end it was just him and a girl alive and everyone else was dead? They were supposed to be the new Adam and Eve and he shoots himself in the head?
Probably.
And he's just like, fuck this, and shoots himself in the head.
I think that
I
like,
can't remember if that was a real
like,
ending
like
or
two or three endings to the thing. And that's part of why I'm just like, come the fuck on, dude. Like, you're not Blade Runner. Shut the fuck up. You know, I don't know. I love Blade Runner. And, you know, badass. I don't want this to sound like that Boss Baby meme, but you know what I'm talking about?
I don't know. I love Boss Baby because I make I make references to Boss Baby all the time. Like when my youngest is four and he outwits my teenagers. I'm just like, what is this? A Boss Baby episode? I make so many corny dad jokes to my children.
There's this tweet that's just like, guy who's only seen Boss Baby watching another movie. Getting real Boss Baby vibes from this movie.
Face.
What person on the planet has only seen Boss Baby?
That shit is so
hilarious.
Funny. Yeah, but like, that's how I felt. Like, I felt like how I felt watching Blade Runner, but like, not as cool watching, you know, Evangelion, because I'm just like, you guys are getting so deep, but fucking why?
NASA. Full of lies.
Yeah,
sorry, go ahead.
I just like
what are you like some conservative white ass nigga? What do you mean NASA's full of lies?
Or maybe I could just say they're full of lies without being conservative or white.
Mm.
Yeah,
oh man,
it's Evangelion for me.
Evangelion. It's really weird to me because what I liked about and we have the similar church background. I feel like a lot of black people do. Vaughn does too, actually.
Yeah.
No, because they have like a lot of. Biblical, religious undertones, maybe like not even undertones, like just straight in your face, like because there was like one of those even those angel robots was on a cross. It was like that's like overtones, honestly. Yeah. But so yeah, I found that interesting. I found their because they would like describe stuff in Revelations in their own way, like oh, this revelation says this, so that means this war angel is going to come down and like humankind is going to try to like control an angel and like send a little kid because his dad is like a mad scientist and tries to fit little like it's like really, and I love that's the, one of the things I love about anime, and I talked to like some coworkers about this how it's just like anime is just so like the Western world animation is just so like. I can show you the world. Tell me, princess. Now, when did you? But like Eastern animation is just like my dad was a mad scientist, and now he has me this piloting this angel. they don't treat their audiences like they're idiots. So like I love Eastern animation, but it's
Oh man, I fucking hate that about a lot of American like dumbing down anything. Like I remember I first encountered that when I was younger when I found out they changed the names of a lot of the Harry Potter books for American audiences.
Mm.
Like instead of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, you know, for
us. It's the
Philosopher's Stone. I'm like, Americans just can't fucking say philosophers? Like that's like fucking beyond us?
That was weird to me. I did notice that.
So aggravating. Yeah. Even with, you know, this is like another anime sort of like segment.
Didn't Harry Potter have a character in it called, like Chang Chu or something?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Cho.
This is Chang Cho?
Yes.
What was her name? Her name was Chang Cho.
She was not brilliant with the names. Mm. Although, like, I remember reading all the books and reading the name Hermione and being like, I feel like I mispronounced it until the movies came out. Because I was like, Hermione.
What's the writer's name?
J.K. Rowling.
Jackass Rowling.
Okay, I'm going to go out on a limb, guys, and say J.K. Rowling's might have not been dealing with a whole deck of cards, you know.
No, it's she was a straight white lady that wrote a story with a bunch of white kids, and then
now's transphobic.
Yeah, that's why. Here's the thing: I never tried to
fucking retcon a bunch of shit. You know,
I got my appreciation from Harry Potter from Vaughn telling me that like I should fucking appreciate it. So I was just like, when he told me, so I was like, okay, that's pretty cool. And then like the whole thing about like the most interesting part was like the guy who fell in love with Harry's mom, but then was just like,
Snape was the most interesting part of. Harry Potter, you son of a bitch.
He was in love with his mom, but there was just like, but like his day was like, okay, I can't get this woman, but because like she chose someone else, I respect her decision. But I'm gonna, you know, I'm gonna take care of their child because they're both dead now. Or whatever.
Wow. And okay. Like, no, this is completely.
Is that how it goes?
No, absolutely not. Snape was a fucking bitch. He did not take care of Harry. He should have taken care of Harry because he was the one who got Harry's parents killed.
Snape got Harry's parents killed?
Oh my god.
I thought it was like Voldemort that killed his
parents. Voldemort killed them because of Snape.
What does Snape do?
Snape's basically just snitched. Like, he was just like, yeah, get the niggas over there. Like, I'm paraphrasing a lot.
Really?
But Snape had the opportunity to like help raise Harry to be like a badass wizard, but he just shat on him for 7 years. That's literally all he did.
No, I thought he was hard on him to make him stronger.
No, absolutely not.
He was just a dick?
He's a complete bitch. At the end, he died, and he was like, oh, I loved your mother. And everyone's like,
have her eyes.
Like, me and Cars called him Snape apologists. They were like, oh, like, oh man. I was like, oh, so.
You guys don't like Snape. So you just want to get fucked by Alan Rickman.
I was like, you know, rest in peace.
Yeah, no, he was.
I feel like because I've not watched any Harry Potter movie or read any of the books.
Which I didn't understand that either. That's
I feel like I just said, Darth Vader's pretty cool. You're just like, no, he's not.
Oh my God. Like, Snape was a complete. Like, Harry Potter could have been like, instead of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, Prisoner of Azkaban. It could have been Harry Potter, that nigga who defeated everybody easily. Because Snape could have, like, he was master of the dark arts. He could have taught him occlumency from jump. But he decided to be a bitch.
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, well, our listeners will, but
will they, Bob?
There's a Harry Potter listener like, yes!
Exactly. Snape was a complete bitch.
Finally, Harry Potter content.
Like, just because you don't know about Harry Potter, there's like a huge fan base.
Actually, I've got a funny Harry Potter story. Fucking, nice. My girlfriend's really into Harry Potter.
I will just say, guys, I'm struggling what to name the podcast. Go ahead.
We'll figure that out later. So, like,
you should name the podcast Colt Doesn't Know Shit.
She's really into Harry Potter.
Actually, I'm down with that.
So, like I saw a couple of the movies, and so, like, I wanted to, like, catch up on them. But I also kind of didn't, because they're all long as fuck.
I love them because I read the books, but they're not super great.
Yeah, there are a couple that are good, but, you know. The Goblet of Fire, like that one. It's basically...
I don't want to go into, like, the books. Oh, my God.
I'm sure
so much
they
stuff,
missed a lot, yeah.
But they did. You know, the books are huge.
But she made a deal with me that if I took her to go see the new Fantastic Beasts movie, that I wouldn't have to watch all these Harry Potter movies. And it was the second Fantastic Beasts movie.
I actually like Beasts movies.
Yeah, of course. They're both amazing.
I wouldn't say amazing, but...
I will say this. Like, I wasn't... You know, like, of course, like, acting ability and stuff like that. But I love them because, like, I'm obviously a fucking massive Harry Potter fan.
Okay.
So I love seeing young Dumbledore. I love seeing, like, really didn't like Grindelwald turning into fucking Johnny Depp.
He was fucking Wizard Hitler, dude.
Wizard Hitler.
No,
he
stayed up. What was the actor that played him?
Colin Farrell. Colin Farrell, yeah.
No. Grindelwald should have stayed Colin Farrell. Like,
yeah, no,
that was
Colin
believable.
Farrell was
that
doing
was
a
sexy.
Great time. Yeah, great
that was,
job.
That was great.
When he turned into Johnny Depp, I was so fucking disappointed.
I feel like the reason they... Okay, because Johnny Depp was
hold on,
going
hold on.
Through.
I was
okay,
watching the second movie, and I'm thinking, like, is this a bad movie, or am I being a dick? Because, like, I don't want to sit here
it's
and,
like, half
shit on the movie, because, like... You know, and so, like, eventually I was watching this Cosmonaut Variety Hour movie, or a video about the movie, and, it was just pointing out all the shit that I, like, noticed and was like, okay, so I'm not crazy. This is a bad movie. Mm-hmm. And I showed my girlfriend this video, and she's like, yeah, I didn't want to give you that. Justify. Yeah, I didn't want to give you the satisfaction of knowing the movie was shit. So I just sat there and was like, well, he doesn't know it's bad. Mm-hmm. So, you know, yeah, the fucking Johnny Depp Wizard of Hitler thing didn't really work for me.
I hated it. I really, really hate that we're probably not going to get like the next one, which would have been the best one, because if you know Harry Potter books, it would have been like...
I think we are getting the next one.
Oh, that would be amazing, because like the next one's supposed to be like the battle between young Dumbledore and Grindelwald, which is like a huge part of Harry Potter.
But I thought they couldn't fight because they were in love or something.
No, I mean like...
They had like their magical butt plug.
No, the wand... You know, here we go. The wand that... The wand that Grindelwald uses in the movie...
Is that not what it was?
You can only receive the Elder Wand through like a duel. You have to win the duel. So it's like
the dark saber.
In all the Harry Potter movies, Dumbledore is carrying the Elder Wand. So of course he has to defeat and kill Grindelwald to get it.
I think they were talking about putting Mads Mikkelsen in instead of Johnny Depp. Like he was just going to change again.
They should just change it back to Colin Farrell.
Long story short, Fantastic Beasts 3 will be released in cinemas on July 15, 2022.
Probably.
Bearing any further delays, of course. Warner Brothers originally, it was thought that the threequel would repeat the 2-year release gap for the first two movies and come out November 20th, 2020. But it set it for November 12th, 2021, and I guess something happened. So there's been a delay in the third one.
They fired Johnny Depp, that's what happened.
Well, they did fire Johnny Depp, but then people... Or just like, okay.
Why'd y'all fire Johnny Depp?
Right, and then it's just when Johnny Depp won the court case against this crazy ex-wife. Yeah, it was just like... it was just like, okay.
I just think they're both shit. That's just me.
they both did some... Okay. I felt like his ex did like...
She did some shit, but like...
She did a bunch of shit to be like playing the victim. Yeah. But Johnny Depp also did some stuff. But it's just like, if you were in that position, wouldn't you like respond in some sort of way? Like, what would... Anyways, I don't know. It's hard to say, but like it's really weird that because Johnny Depp lost Pirates and this
and like just everything,
and
else.
She didn't lose, and like people are trying to make it that she loses Aquaman, but she hasn't lost it, so
she probably won't. I don't think she is. I think they like actually said they're not gonna like get rid of her in an article,
which is
well, but
shit.
Like WB is a dumpster fire anyway. So,
I mean, yeah, they had Zack Snyder at the helm for who knows how long.
Snyder's version of Justice League, I felt was good. Like, I felt like the studio ruined
it. Interviews about the Batman movies, where he's just like, I want to, like, where Batman can get, like, raped in prison in, like, my universe. That's
Jesus.
That's the kind of Batman I'm like.
Is that what you said verbatim?
Yeah. Like,
Jesus.
Yeah, like, this. Yeah. And I thought, oh, this might have been taken out of context. No, it's on video.
Sad fucking face.
Like, it's like Zack Snyder makes some stuff that I enjoy, but I still think he's a dumpster fire of a person.
Speaking of a dumpster fire, I just ordered from Moe's, and they just canceled my order.
Oh.
Fuck those guys.
Welcome to bed.
It's 9. They're not even closed yet. I feel like they close at 10.
They close at 10.
Why did they cancel your order? Did you order something, like, ridiculously complicated?
Nachos?
Oh. I thought you were just like,
why would you even do that to yourself, Vaughn? By the time they get here, they're going to be terrible.
They always separate it.
Oh,
do they?
I know what I'm doing.
This isn't my first rodeo.
Yeah, okay.
This is his second rodeo.
Yeah, because the first time they didn't separate.
God, the delivery fee on Tacos Tequila's Mexican Grill on fucking Roswell World is $20.
Holy shit.
I should go there and smack the shit out of everybody.
Jesus
Christ.
Okay,
you let me know. Dude, did I have enough Elijah? Did I already have my...
Yeah.
Of Elijah Craig, or can I have some?
No, I'm sorry. I just put it so it'd be out of the camera. I wasn't like trying
I thought you were
enforcing it.
I will say, that's part of what makes me not want to move Elijah out of the suburbs Craig. Is
when your co-host is putting
fees,
it out of the camera.
Man.
Drink some Elijah Craig.
Because the most a fucking Uber Eats like delivery fee or whatever will be in my neck of the woods is like $4.50, you know? So like $20 on top of what you're already getting.
Yeah, I'm like, fuck you, Uber.
I'm
still about to give
you
money.
I just pass away at that point. You know?
All right, so what's the next topic?
Beastars. Is it made by furries? Is it technically hentai? What do we think?
No. Well, first of all,
is that going to be the name of the podcast, B-Stars? I got to look this shit up because I don't know what the
The name of the podcast should be, is it hentai or not? let's do that. Let's start with B-Stars and go through a list of animes and be like, is it hentai or not?
Let's do that. Because there are a couple.
Oh, the high school. What is the zombie high school?
High School of the Dead. Very, very edgy.
Dude, it is fucking hentai. Is it hentai with a good storyline, but it's still fucking hentai?
Give me a second. Me and my woman are ordering Chipotle now because Moses. You know what? It wasn't Moses.
B-Stars. Is it B-Stars in anime?
Yeah, B-E-A-S-T-A-R-S.
It doesn't, it's...
Yep, that's it.
Oh, I've seen memes about this. Is it like fucking...
Because it's like, what is it about? Is it about like classism? Is it about like racial inequality?
Oh, is the hentai stuff supposed to be a metaphor for some shit?
That's what I'm saying.
Or
I don't
does
know.
It just fucking... hentai.
There's a fuck bunny.
Make get you like hard on. It's just like, oh,
where
this is
going?
About the.
Are you going somewhere?
I'm going to get a cigarette. So.
Okay, Colt gets a cigarette.
Because Vaughn left, so I was just like, dude, this doesn't make.
We'll be right back with the podcast, but in the meantime, I'm going to plug my other work. So how about you check out Indistinct Conversation Podcast and Working Class Music while you're at it. We'll be right back to the Punk Black Podcast.
Is this yours? What is this?
We are Working Class Music, and we love Jazz Masters. Just a couple of updates. Thank you for subscribing to not only our YouTube channel, but our Patreon as well. We definitely appreciate it, and we want to thank you for that. So, just to let you guys know, we do a little giveaways every now and then. So, today, we're not quite reviewing something. We're actually announcing another giveaway that we're doing. Once we hit 3,000 subs on our YouTube channel, we're giving away this Daphne Blue Jazz Master. It is a Squire Affinity Mini?
Mini! It looks like a normal size guitar on me.
Yeah, it's Tia size. Yeah, so all you gotta do is just like, subscribe, and comment. And if you feel generous, join our Patreon.
I finally realized it. Guitar guys like me are sword guys who have had sex.
Yeah.
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 We're still obsessed with some stupid inanimate object like it's gonna make our life better, but we have had sex one time, and that's the difference.
At least one time.
Yeah.
Yeah. At least once.
What were we talking about?
We were talking about anime. Is it hentai?
Oh,
fucking B-Stars.
Yeah. It's like B-Stars. Is it hentai?
I didn't see it. I've seen the memes. I'm just like,
I think there are parts of it that are. I think it's got notes of hentai.
I'm gonna say like B-Stars is definitely leaning on a hentai.
That fucking fuck bunny, get out of here.
Yeah, like you know,
get out of here.
Because the difference between hentai and ecchi, because ecchi, you know, like you see a lot of flashes of you know girls' butts. You see like you know. Obvious, like, sexual innuendos.
You mean, like High School of the Dead?
High School of the Dead is, like, hardcore edgy.
But, like, B-Stars is almost
hentai.
Just straight up
not
see
hentai.
A wolf's
because hentai is basically porn.
Exactly. Okay. No, not basically. It is porn.
Yes, hentai is porn.
Well, we answered that shit.
High School of the Dead, what is that? I don't know if I'm familiar.
High School of the Dead? Oh, it's actually like sort of a classic zombie anime. It's actually really, really good. I loved it when I was younger, but like, I like it, but like, I feel really weird about watching it now because it's just like fucking like so much ecchi with like high school, like obvious ecchi with high school girls. And I'm just like,
okay, do you guys feel
really
like
trying to enjoy the storyline, but
Cowboy Bebop had ecchi shit in it?
Yes.
Yeah, but like Cowboy Bebop's etchiness was like,
it was real.
Magically tasteful.
Yeah.
I feel like the movie had way more. Because, like, what is the main girl character?
Faye
was like, Faye was like tied up the whole movie and tied up a really sexual, like, oh, I'm tied up. I can't get away. And oh, here go my boobs. And it's just like, dude.
I mean,
because I like Cowboy Bebop, but I want to show it to you. It was just like, my children just like, hey, you know, all this artistic anime you're watching, it came from Cowboy Bebop. Cowboy Bebop changed the game, but it's just like, Cowboy Bebop is that so much ecchi shit.
I mean,
it really doesn't have a lot of ecchi stuff in Cowboy Bebop. Like,
maybe I'm thinking of the movie
I don't know.
More
I saw,
than the action.
It was really only that one part in the movie.
I saw a tweet by Father where he was unsatisfied with the live action Cowboy Bebop cast because
It wasn't the girl wasn't.
Yeah, I guess Faye wasn't as
cute enough. A bunch of people have said that.
Yeah, she was
not
cute enough. Or just as
she wasn't showing enough skin for people. That's what I feel like, and I feel like
I'm like trying to find the right word.
Feel like Netflix is trying.
Right word. Yeah, it's like I want to say busty
because it's like fucking you know. I love anime, but Japanese culture in general. It like just like.
Are you at least happy that the cast isn't a bunch of white people?
I am happy with that, but it just like it treats women like the just in general, like the way they treat women in general in anime is always
any better in America though.
It's gotten better. Is it completely better than anime? I would say yes. Like a lot. Well, it depends on what you're watching.
Wait. What'd you say is completely better than anime?
As far as just like how they treat women, Western culture to Eastern culture.
I wonder how Megan Fox feels about that.
I feel like that is like a I don't know. That's a war where nobody wins because I feel like no. Eastern culture and Western culture like both treat women like shit.
Yeah,
especially like their portrayal like in movies and stuff like that. Like,
it depends on what you're watching though.
Iron Man 2, that like half of that whole.
And I feel like since Black the Widow Me Too movement, there's ass. Been like, you know, there's.
Like rewatch Iron Man 2. That
you seen a Michael
fight?
Bay film?
Right, that's what I was like, ask Megan.
Okay,
Fox,
that's what I'm saying.
Dude,
if you're watching like, Michael Bay films, yes, Michael Bay's a piece of shit. And just like.
Do you ever
But you can say the same thing about like the Eastern culture movies you're talking about. I was like, just watch a different movie is literally what you're saying right now.
I'm talking about anime though.
Again, watch a different anime. Not all animes have edgy stuff in them.
I guess
there are thousands of animes.
Thousands.
Tens of thousands.
Yes, no, there's so much anime, but I feel like okay, what percentage anime you feel like makes women's bodies
realistic?
No, makes women's bodies like a subject matter. What percentage would you say if there's thousands of animes? Would you say 50%?
60%.
I'll say 65%.
Objectify women?
Have you seen One Piece?
I'll say 65%.
No, I didn't want my children to watch One Piece. My son, when he heard that, I was just like, I'm never watching One Piece. He's like, oh, I'll try it. And then he's watching. I'm just like,
because everything from their waist boobs, just goes into
boobs everywhere. Boobs all over the town. It's like,
It's like, I can't even, like, it makes me laugh whenever I see, like, One Piece shit. Because I'm just like, really now? Come on.
Right.
Come on, dude.
But even like animes who really don't have a lot of ecchi, I feel like they have hints of it. They have hints of like, oh, this girl's like laying on the ground and then her shirt's slightly open, her shirt. And it's just like,
yeah, you can't just like, I mean, like, of course you can like, I guess you can generalize anime how you want to. But like, again, same thing, all American culture movies, like, you
not
watch a
all
movie.
Of them, not all
like,
of them.
But
the
same thing, like anime. Have you seen Psycho Pass?
I haven't seen Psycho Pass.
Psycho Pass has not one fucking lick of ecchi in it.
No, there are animes that don't have one link of ecchi in it, but would you say that most animes don't have it? Or would you say more animes, would you say it's half and half or more animes do have it?
Again, I said 65%, but I would say
65% is more than.
I would say most, but I would say the same thing for American culture. I would say like 65% as well.
You would say 65% of American movies.
Sex sells, baby.
No, I feel Americans were literally the people who came up with the term sex sells. Yeah. I don't know if that's the actual truth. You can look it up. I'll look it up as well.
I'll say Europeans ruined Japanese people by like when they, with the, what is it? What's the word where Europeans come to a culture and take it over? What is it called?
Colonization.
They like ruin, like they just like made people feel like no, being into sex is bad and you need to like censor it and shit like that. And they've just like they censor their porn and all sorts of shit.
So. Religious ones, and the religious ones were the worst ones.
Okay. Yes, they were. I'm agreeing with you, Vaughn.
So
I'm saying
guys,
that though.
You ever talk about how weird it is that Japanese porn is censored, but it's still porn?
Exactly.
Yes.
I don't understand.
That is actually pretty crazy.
I don't know what to name this episode.
Is it hentai? How long is it going?
One of these days, I'm going to make a real email for the fake emails. I'm going to like make a real vomitingthisistiredofthisshit.com@gmail.
How long have we been going? I think we can, if we have a strong closer, we can roll into that.
We've been going for 35 minutes.
said 35 minutes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it seems like longer, but it hasn't been.
It's only been 35 minutes.
Do you have another topic? You're the king of topics. Come on. Here you go. Flex your muscle. What's the next topic, my dude?
Okay, the next topic.
Oh, we didn't talk about the Spider-Man trailer. Yeah, I was going to bring
that up. The fucking Spider-Man trailer.
Finally dropped first before the real trailer dropped. The trailer where it was...
Why are you yelling?
I've had too much Elijah Craig. No, I've had too much.
Nope. We're on camera.
Island John Vodka. Island John Vodka. Get some vodka in your life. It's black owned.
When you get older, it's between the memory and the hearing. Yeah. It's one of those things. They start. Just
whoops.
Shwoof.
I can't wait until I'm in my 50s and you guys get into your 40s and I can. And I'll you still guys be would fucking, be.
I'll we'll
be
still like 30, be 10 years younger.
Yeah, I'll be like 31 when you're 50. So, I mean, I don't know what you mean.
Wait, y'all are 20 years apart. Y'all are 15 years apart.
Yeah, yeah. No, he'll be like mid 30s. He'll be like 36 when I'm 50.
But still.
But I'm saying, 30s were rough also, guys. When your joints start hurting, I'm going to make fun of you, is what
my
I'm saying.
My joints already hurt, dude.
No, you've got dark days ahead, though.
Yeah, I know, yeah. No,
it's going to be even worse.
That's why I'm fucking going back to the gym, because I creak.
Oh, same. Yeah. I'm going back to the gym. Vaughn's going back to the gym. Well, mostly because I need to lose my quarantine weight, and I need to get up my breathing, because I'm in a band again, and I can't run out of breath.
Oh, my cardio is fucking insane.
Which band are you in, Colt?
I am in Howling Star. That's about to play Afropunk Fest. But here's the thing. I was thinking, we got so many likes. So, you guys are playing Afropunk. You guys are playing. How long is Afropunk going to be like the standard?
Until we edge them out?
I don't think Afropunk is a standard.
Well, no. If we said we were playing Punk Black Fest, it wouldn't get as much. Well, it's because we started Punk Black.
It would. It's,
I think it would.
And it's really how you work it.
It got us the free bottle of vodka.
No, Vaughn. Afropunk.
Yeah, exactly. And I've made plenty of statuses about Punk Black lately. And they did really well. Way better than the one did today.
I'm saying a lot of people hold Afropunk as the standard of success if you're playing their festival, even though they've sold and then been bought out by Essence.
Which a lot of people just do not know.
Yeah.
They sort of refuse to, I don't know. It's really weird.
It's probably because they've been around longer.
They've been around longer, and I feel like a lot of people's introduction or diving in internet-wise to their alternative black lifestyle was like, you know, funded or like not funded, but
you got it.
What's the word?
would you cut this face out and it looks like it's just like
what is it?
Having really bad.
We're just like, okay, respect your elders, my niggas.
Just leave all of that.
Like they were just like basically Afropunk was part of their, you know, maturity into their alternative black self. So
I mean, it wasn't that for me. It was actually Punk Black that was that for me. It's, well, I mean, yeah.
Hey, Punk Black.
Yeah, you guys got me while I was still a youngin.
And we met you before we started Punk Black, which is awesome.
You did.
Yeah, we did.
My band at that Battle of the Bands, that was totally rigged because my band should have won. Never forget that.
It was rigged because the Battle of the Bands was so easy.
Hey. If you guys didn't know, Nelson had a band a long time ago. And our first band that I was in with Vaughn
smited his band off the face of the earth. They no longer exist.
And we fucking forgot about it. And then we were like interviewing Nelson for the podcast back when I used to do it my fucking self. And he was just like, oh, remember you guys beat my Battle of the Bands? And we were just like, what are you talking? I wish that
we didn't remember. So he held a photograph. Look at this photograph.
That was the worst day of my life. For me, it was only Tuesday.
Right. Basically, it was just like Scarlet Witch, you ruined my life. And he was just I don't even know who you are. But we knew who Nelson was. Yeah. We knew his new band. We loved it. We were just like my old band where I only played basic guitar.
I played bass and did vocals.
Because you were the black guy. They made you play bass.
No, it was just the easiest instrument to play.
Respect.
Shout out the bass players.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I remember playing the show, but I don't remember it being a Battle of the Bands. The thing I remember about playing that show at the warehouse, it doesn't exist anymore. Nope. I remember playing the show. I remember this young white girl coming to me asking me to dance. I'm like, 28, and you're like 15.
Yeah.
And I was just like, oh yeah, we could dance. And I just started like shaking and jumping around and stuff and running around the venue, and she was running after me and stuff. I was just like, okay, this is not.
Yeah.
No. I wanted to like dance with her and not it be like a thing, but she was just like running around and being like, all right, kid, I don't.
As a formerly horny young person, there was a lot of those running around.
There was no way to get out of that. Yeah, like, no, I don't, like, so I was just like, no, I'm not a pedophile. This new Spider-Man trailer, ma'am. Oh, right, Spider-Man trailer. Spider-Man. All right, you guys want to watch it again to get
I've seen it.
Oh, yeah. Also, before we talk about the Spider-Man trailer.
We can play it. I'll plug it in right now.
Oh, look at this. This is a good one. Some suggest that Parker's powers include the male spider's ability to hypnotize females.
Stop. Come on.
Yes, my spider lord.
Can we just, like, stay up here all day? It is so crazy down there.
That's right, folks. Spider-Man is, in fact, Peter Parker.
Listen, I did not kill Mysterio. The drones did.
The drones that are yours.
Does any part of you feel relieved about all this?
What do you mean?
Now that everybody knows, you don't really have to hide or lie to people.
For the record, I never wanted to lie to you. But how do you tell someone that you're Spider-Man? Now everybody knows. But this isn't about me. This is hurting a lot of people. I've just been thinking about how to fix all of this.
So, Peter, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I'm sorry to bother you, sir.
Please, we saved half the universe together. I think we're beyond you calling me sir.
Okay, Steven.
That feels weird, but I'll allow it.
When Mysterio revealed my identity, my entire life got screwed up. I was wondering if maybe you could make it so that he never did.
Strange.
Don't cast that spell. It's too dangerous. Fine. I won't.
The entire world is about to forget that Peter Parker is Spider-Man.
Wait, everyone? Can't some people still know?
That's not how the spell works.
So MJ's gonna forget about everything we've ever been through?
Stop tampering with the spell.
Oh my God, Ned, he's my best friend. Oh, my Aunt May should really know.
Stop talking.
What just happened?
We tampered with the stability of space-time. The multiverse is a concept about which we know frighteningly little. The problem is you trying to live two different lives. The longer you do it, the more dangerous it becomes. Be careful what you wish for, Parker.
Hello, Peter.
Before we talk about the Spider-Man trailer, I have like a slight confession.
Uh-oh. What's up? You haven't seen it?
I lied. We're at 66 minutes right now.
Okay, that's like fucking 35 minutes. You're out of your fucking mind.
We're going to do the Spider-Man trailer. Then we're
we can
like,
close on the Spider-Man
and then
trailer.
Then we'll do the music and then we'll close
out. Yeah, we've got to do our top three. You guys make sure to send me those.
Y'all
want to
make some food after this?
Them.
Where at?
I don't know.
I thought it was just Uber Eats.
We can go to Boggs. All the stuff on Uber Eats is like not.
I'm cool with going to Boggs. Are they open late?
Yeah.
It's only 9. Okay, cool.
Do they still have the meat pies there?
It is the Lord's Day, though.
Are you doing a podcast with your closest friends, but you're all hungry?
Yeah, this just divulged.
Go to Boggs on the West End. Boggs on the West End.
Oh, they're open till 12 a.m.
Hell yeah, dude.
What? On a Sunday? Doing God's work. That's what I'm fucking talking about.
I'm not super hungry, but I'll have a drink and take some meat pies for the road.
And I just grabbed some food for Karis from there.
And I would
too.
Love to hang out with Nelson outside of this because he only comes when.
Yes. Look at that. Solidarity.
He only comes when we do the podcast.
You can
I would
see
like
it on
to
the Spotify podcast right now, but they were holding hands.
Yes. Yes.
We don't buy into. What is it?
Fragile something masculinity.
Yeah, we don't buy into fragile masculinity here. No, we show affection. Fucking, we hug. We high five. We say I love you. We don't fucking do that shit. But
Colt never says he loves me.
I love you, Phoenix.
Oh, okay. Oh, all right. Oh, wow. I love you too. Wow.
I never really tell anybody. I tell my children and my wife that I love them, but like outside of that, I don't like. And that's fair. That's fair. I remember Avi used to always say, "I love you." I was just like, "Okay."
Dude, no. Have you seen that thing? It's like say it because
Avi is like a poet. He's like a good with words. He's really good with words. But like, yeah, and I used to like he would do like poetry at the what is it?
People are waiting for
Jabba Monkey. Jabba Monkey. I work right next to it, and he'd be like, "I love you, man." I was just like, "Yeah, man. I've known you for like 2 weeks."
Cool. Oh man, like you should like see like my dad's face the first time I was talking to Avian, and I was like on the phone. I was like, it was like a bunch of business stuff. I was like, "Yeah, yeah. So yeah, do that. We're gonna meet at this time." Blah blah blah. My dad's looked like, "Look at my son, get it." And then yeah, Avian's like, "All right, man, I love you." And I was like, "All right, love you too." My dad was like,
"Who?" Han's dead. Born a long time ago, military guy, has told me insane military stories, like while we're all around, pull guns out at band practice.
Which is not the most, he told me the most insane military story recently. I had no idea that he was like one of like the operators and like that used to like get like and all that kind of stuff.
What?
He's, you know, I don't know if it's long enough for me to tell you this. I'll tell you, I guess, over some drinks at Boggs, but. Insane. He had like he was almost part of
like fucking like, millions of people. Okay, well Von's dead is like
sorry,
okay.
Y'all want to hear that story?
That's hilarious. It's just like yeah, no, all right, mm-hmm. Yeah, love you too.
he's like it was even, well, he didn't even say anything about it, but his face was like, "Who's he talking
why
to?"
Why you tell this nigga you love him? It's,
well,
I know he said brother a couple times.
Right, he didn't even know it was like yeah. You know, we don't tell men we love each other.
No, my
we
mom
just grimace fucking, at each other and don't like acknowledge our affection.
My mom gave me shit about that because I said I love you getting off the phone with my friend. She was like, "When's the last time you said I love you to one of your actual brothers?" And I was like, "I don't fucking know, dude. They suck. Like, I don't fucking
no,
I mean,
no.
I do, but like, I'm like."
I will say that men in like in a lot of ways in our culture don't express our affection, but I feel like
it's good that we do.
No, it's good that we do, and I feel like in punk areas, we do say it. I remember when, I don't know if you remember, Nelson, but you were on stage with your old band, and you had messed up, and you needed a ride home.
That's
and,
another story.
Oh, and we were trying
are
to cheer
tell
you
that
up.
Story?
No, no, we don't have to tell the whole story, but I'm saying you needed to be cheered up, so I was just like, we were trying to get a ride with you home, because I felt like they left you or whatever, but I was just
and he's still.
No, I was just like, it's okay, man. I gave you, I hugged you and gave you a kiss on the cheek. And
I don't think
just
it's bad now, because it's like, I feel like it's part of Nelson's character development.
I think I've told the story on my other podcast.
I will say, though, no, dude, I fucked up with my band and my friends, like, we've all fucked up in certain ways or whatever.
That's why
I was like quick to like, dude, it's fine. We'll get past this. And I like hugged you and gave you a kiss on the cheek.
I remember that.
Because it was just like, and then after I kissed you, you smiled. You're just like, oh, thanks, man.
Yeah, you put me in the car and I was like venting.
I felt like Vaughn put you in the car. I felt like I wasn't around
somebody
for
putting
put
me
in
the car. And I was just venting.
We all put you in the car that day.
Man, oh boy. I mean, that was a snake bitch show to begin with.
Dude, no, I feel like in general, like, you look at it like something that you did, but, like, I have times of me drinking too much or whatever. Vaughn has times of him drinking too much. Like, we all have, like, we all have these stories, my dude.
That night.
Yeah, we all have stories about this shit. So it's just like, you know.
It was crazy to me because, like, to be honest, that whole punk black was already a clusterfuck.
Exactly.
Like we had booked way too many bands in a small time frame. Like back in the day, like whenever we thought punk black festival, we're like, we got 5 hours. Let's throw 20 bands at 5 hours.
Like
some dumbasses. Yeah, like times are already super behind. Like people are already complaining.
Sure? I had too much time. Got too.
Is
drunk,
your friend awesome? And he gave you the last gummy. Make sure it's a Royal Snacks neon gummy worms.
I just remember like being at the bar.
Pay us.
I was sitting
they
at the
better pay us shit. I'm always fucking. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was sitting at the bar because like I had just put out another fire, and I was like, I like sipped a little bit of whiskey and coke, and I was like, okay. Things. I was like, Vaughn. I was giving myself a pep talk. I was like, bro, it's gonna be okay, man. Just sip on this. The night's gonna be smooth. Mateo like. In Mateo dramatic fashion, comes down fucking Union stairs, which are like basically like a 90 degree angle. So if you come down those things fast, it's an emergency or you're drunk. So like he comes down the stairs, he's like, yeah, I think Nelson is drunk. And I was like, well,
yeah,
no, probably not.
I remember I was following on stage, and I think I was the first one to jump on stage, but like, dude.
Yeah.
Are you okay?
No, it's crazy.
He wasn't okay, but it was just like, dude.
Colt was helpful at that time, but Colt was also on one that...
Yes, that show. But I wasn't singing with my band, so it didn't fucking matter.
Yeah, exactly. He's also on that show. I remember going upstairs, I was like, yeah, I don't think Nelson's drunk. And he's like tuning his guitar, but he's been like tuning like the same string for like 6 minutes. I watched him for a second because I was like, no, he's not drunk. And he's doing the same gang. And I saw like, but his band was like, dude, he's been. I was like, okay. I was like, oh, all right, he might be a little drunk. So I was like, Nelson, do you think that you're groovy? He was like, but again, this is like character.
I was like, yeah, I'm fine, man.
This is like character development for Nelson. To me, it's just like, because now we just. Gave him the podcast. Like this is all character development.
I got that. I got this from that.
Exactly. And like, I will say, like, I feel like when I was Nelson's age and younger, I was the same. I was a little shit.
I think I was 23 or 24.
Exactly. Well. I was definitely some stupid shit.
I don't feel comfortable. If we bring up Nelson's shit, we have to bring up our shit.
Two months ago,
me and Vaughn.
So the spoiler is going to happen.
We and Vaughn went to
Boggs.
Had a drink, and we're just like, oh, let's go to track
Flatiron.
Flatiron. Let's do Flatiron. Went to Flatiron. Met awesome people. Had more drinks, and then they were just like, hey, we just were pre gaming for the. Lady Gaga dance party at the basement. We were just like, oh, we didn't even fucking know about that. We know everybody at the basement anyway, so let's go fucking do it. And then we went there, and then me and Bomb both blacked out. And then when we both came to, we were like somewhere completely different. We were at like Edgewood, like at a fucking... Church? And I took the church bar. Oh, I have a bunch of pictures of like... Well, I deleted it all because they were just like blurry-ass pictures, but it's just like... me and Vaughn were just like, how do we end up on Edgewood?
For people who don't know what Edgewood in Atlanta is, you have to be either drunk or generally nonsensible to go to Edgewood on the weekend.
Yeah.
Even though I love places like there, like our bar, shout out to them, they're fucking dope. But Edgewood is a complete clusterfuck on the weekends.
It is just like, there's no place to park. Because when I came to, we were trying to find our place to park. Like, Vaughn took a picture of the signs. Like, it was just, like, probably, like, a 15-minute walk from the bar we're at.
Slightly more sober, Vaughn, like, was
Holy
looking out for
shit.
Us.
I just remember, I've got a really, really bad story from fucking church.
Maybe we shouldn't go to just, like, a bunch of awful shit showing how awful we've been.
It's short. I was fucking... He gives me some and it's just like, take your out. I'm like, nah,
this
man.
Has been Punk Stories with the Punk Black Podcast.
Oh, yes. I think people will figure out we're just not going to talk about the Spider-Man trailer.
No, let's... Okay, wait.
Here
we go. Right, let's talk about the Spider-Man.
We'll talk about it next time. We're at 80 minutes.
We don't want to talk... It will be like
20 minutes I have to cut out.
By our next podcast, it'll be... Okay, you guys want to just do the music?
It doesn't come out until December.
Okay, fair enough. All right, so let's just do the music. Okay, I like the trailer.
The Spider-Man trailer was great. I think the Otto Octavius thing is a misdirect. There's probably going to be another villain in there that we don't know.
Do you guys think that this is the real Doctor Strange who did the spell?
No.
I don't think so either. I feel like it's a variant from Loki. I feel it's the Loki variant.
Well, Doctor Strange didn't fuck it up. Peter did.
No, I feel like that was a lie. The fact that he's doing a spell and Peter's talking too much,
or
that's fucking stupid.
He fucked it up on purpose.
Yeah, no, it was Loki. I feel like it was Loki trying to fuck shit up to try to do whatever the fuck
I was really
Loki's
surprised
doing.
That, like, he even did the spell, especially after, like, his entire first move was based off time control.
That's what I'm saying.
That's why Wong was like, don't fucking do this, bro.
It's probably not him. But, yeah, so let's talk about our top threes.
I can't remember what I did last time, so I'm going
to
try to
send me these links so I don't have to go find them.
That should be the name of the podcast. I can't remember what I did last time.
Yeah, so that was a story about how
probably
this is a story about how I started a fight with a gay married couple at. That was my story.
To the bar.
The bar, yes, the bar.
But it could totally happen on a regular.
I mean, there can be gay couples at a.
Okay,
they can
so
be anywhere.
My top three.
They're everywhere. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna do. No, no, they're just, yeah, you are. They're every, you're right, they're everywhere. It's just like why people like try to put it in a cage. God. Okay, I'm gonna do some local shit. I'm gonna do.
What are we doing now?
We're just going through our top.
I'm gonna do top three. Hunter, H A V N T R.
You just a send song it to called me. Send It to Me.
No, No Good by Hunter. That's what I'm gonna do. My first one. I don't hit a nigga too. I don't fuck a bitch too. Nigga, we ain't never lost. You ain't seen what we've been through. I done hit a nigga too. Pew, 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 pew. I done fucked a bitch too. Wow, wow. Nigga, we ain't never lost. You ain't seen what we been through.
Fuck that, fuck that.
My life, I don't know no good. What I do for you. And I know, my life, no good. My second one is an old school, really old school track by Lady Tron called 17. By Lady Tron.
It already stopped recording, like when you said the first thing.
Oh, damn.
The audio or the video?
The audio. We ran out.
Oh,
we ran out.
We ran out of space.
No, we don't.
I'm just fucking with you. It's still recording. Okay,
that's video. Damn. Vaughn, that's not a thing. Vaughn, you're so immature.
Vaughn, you rascal.
Vaughn, you're such a.
Who else but Vaughn?
Such a fucking Vaughn Phoenix. Okay, and my last song is going to be...
Wait, what was the second one?
The second one was an old school one, which was Lady Tron, 17.
Okay.
That's a early 2000s, a really good message, a really dope song.
I'm surprised you like that song. I was actually more a fan of 18 than 17.
Fun, you need to leave.
I'm pulling a coat right now.
And then my last good song is by Hometown Heroes, Manchester Orchestra from Georgia.
Wait, you mean it's... Oh, never mind. Sorry. You said
Manchester Orchestra.
It's by Hometown Heroes?
Yeah, they're from Georgia. They're,
I know.
Oh, no, not the band Hometown... Is there a band called Hometown Heroes?
Probably.
Probably, yeah. Honestly, you know, there's so many bands. Okay, Manchester Orchestra, Bedhead. I'm afraid you're alone. Oh, my God. I love the single. I love the song. It's poppy or whatever, but poppy rock, but I love the fuck out of the song and I love the video. So that's it.
Nice. Vaughn, what do you got? Maybe next time.
Next time. Agreed. I did not prepare.
It'll save me some time in editing anyway.
Awesome.
That's fine.
My first one is a song by Fun called Light a Roman Candle with Me.
Wait. Fun, the band? Fun?
Yeah.
Are they still doing music?
No, this is from their old album,
okay,
Ignite.
Okay, cool.
Light a Roman candle with me. Just a Roman candle. You can wear your sandals and I'll pour you just one cup of tea. Then you can go and rest. You haven't seen my best, so just spend an evening with me. Just a lazy evening that you could be leaving all week, staying talking till three.
The second one I got is a song called Lo Que Siento by Cuco.
Okay.
It's good. When you hear it, you're gonna fucking love it.
Alone, baby, don't trip, I'm coming home.
And then my last one is After the Party by the Menzinger, because that song fucking rules.
Okay, cool. I can't wait to hear that shit, even though I feel like we used to, like, play shit and, like, here.
Close out the podcast, baby, so we can go to Boggs. And,
is
the thing still recording?
No.
Bet. Okay, everything's cut off.
It's all cut off?
Wait, is the audio recording, Phoenix?
I don't know what's happening.
I hope it's recording.
Can you reset the camera so I can close this goddamn son of a bitch out?
All right.
Come over here, let's end this son of a bitch. So yeah, this has been the Punk Black Podcast. My name's Ben Nelson Crawford, and I've been here with,
I'm the Arcade Coat. Hello.
Yeah, and Vaughn has just ceased to exist. But we will see you next time in another week or so. We do this every 2 weeks, twice a month. And if you want to see more, go to punkblack.com. Follow us on Facebook. Just look up Punk Black. Follow us on Instagram, at punkblack.com. On Twitter as well.
Yeah. We're
fucking everywhere, baby.
Everywhere.
Punk Black like Fest a disease. Is in October, the 10th and the 11th.
Like coronavirus.
There are going to be a bunch of fucking bands there.
October is going to be insane.
Make sure you get vaccinated.
Sure.
Wear a mask.
Absolutely.
Stay blessed. Peace.
I have a pop-up blocker.
Alright, so we going
goodbye.
To Boggs or what?
Alright, now they're done with their exit. Now it's time for the real sexy Punk Black exit. Yeah, we're dropping out of this podcast. This is Vaughn Phoenix with the mother niggas. Yeah, that's the end. Niggas. Yeah. Look in the caption if you want to find their Instagrams, but it's not important. Just look at me, Vaughn Phoenix. All right, bye.